professional wrestling's number one program, Nitro Live. And oh my goodness, that is an NWO limousine. Tony Schiavone, Larry Zbyszko, Mike Bonet.
There they are, the Rat Pack.
The NBA had its fair share of bad boy figures throughout the 90s, but none were as divisive as Rodzilla. As famous off the field for his antics as on, Rodman was a natural attention grabber and all-around psychopath.
His point, they're trying to grab him, and now he throws his jersey back out of court, very upset, will not leave.
Well, Dennis better get moving, or there will be more repercussions.
Water, something went flying.
Dennis Rodman, extremely.
Well, now the shorthand.
Sweet! Coming up March 16th, NWOites, don't say that Hollywood doesn't deliver. And Uncensored, the most censored man in America, Howard Stern take a back seat. The newest member of the NWO, Big Brah, you've definitely earned your colors, my friend, because whether it's your new movie Double Team or you and me triple teaming, NWO, man, is your style for life, my friend.
We can do a double team, triple team, but the NWO is the new team of the future.
Sweet.
So once Rodman hung up the Reeboks in the mid-90s and started what would be a long-term romance with Hulk Hogan and cocaine, we saw the formation of the double team, triple team of the future, and the subsequent debut of the Hot Rod. Rod the Bod had officially joined World Championship Wrestling as the newest member of the scorchingly hot New World Order, whipping crowds everywhere into a frenzy with his iconic catchphrase.
He may be bigger than me, but you know what they say, the old cliche, the bigger they are.
Weirdly, Rodman insisted on referring to his opponent, Lex Luger, as a certain non-wrestling villain.
You know, we got Lex Luthor, we got the giant in the back there. That's right, baby, so giant Lex Luthor, where you at?
The climax of the Worm's time in WCW was to be a tag match versus another NBA Hall of Famer in Carl the Mailman Malone. Look, Rodman struggled with substance abuse throughout his career, and his time in WCW was certainly no exception, as Chris Kanyon, a talented superstar in the company at the time, noted in a later interview.
Rodman was a douche, didn't take it serious. Showed up, definitely seemed impaired, which is dangerous. Anytime you wrestle impaired, but he's showing up to train, it's something he doesn't know what the fuck he's doing, showing up impaired. Smelled like shit, out and out shit, smelled horrible. But it smelled like he was partying for 3 or 4 days and didn't shower. It was horrible working. And Malone was the absolute opposite. Took it serious, worked hard, had good ideas. Rodman was so bad, Hulk had to threaten him. Hulk went straight up to him and said, Dennis, calm the fuck down and relax. You gotta work with us. We're all working together. You can either work with us or work against us. And if you work against us, you're not gonna be happy. And that was the end of that.
And that was it. Rodman's double team, triple team of the future was over, and he returned to the NBA, putting an end to his wrestling career. Wait, what's that? When? Where? Australia? Oh, God. Ah, so I guess that wasn't the end of Rodman. In 2003, Australian promotion World Wrestling All-Stars propositioned the Rodzilla for a one-time-only, unsanctioned street fight with the legendary Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig. Was Rodman's experience in WCW finally going to culminate into a bloody war of sweat and tears? Could the great Rodzilla finally enter the annals of deathmatch history joining the likes of Cactus Jack and Terry Funk?
Telling you. Here we go. Here comes a
punch. Yeah, no.
Dennis Rodman is looking in terrible shape now. He looks like he's playing on a last place team.
I'm telling you, you can see by the expression on his face, he's hurt. He's looking for some air.
He looks like a bull with those two earrings hanging out of his nose.
I'm telling you, I would...
Should wrestling world heavyweight.
Oh, drove his head into that table and just took that table apart.
The match was a total disaster. From a wooden table going into business for itself, to Mr. Perfect selling like an extra in Simon Says.
Wait for the kill now. Don't underestimate Kurt Hennig. Over the top rope all the way to the floor. Match. Anything goes. Foreign objects are okay.
Rod the Bod disqualified himself in a freaking no DQ match. And alas, the professional squared circle career of Rodzilla was over. But hey, at least he got an action figure.
Match is over.
Unbelievable!
This match is over. Dennis Rodman has forfeited this match.